Bonjour, bonjour everyone. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Cyril. I have been a stem cell researcher for quite some time, and this is why I can tell you about the science that is behind skincare ingredients. So for today's video, I'm going to review probably the latest sunscreen from Bioderma. This is the Family Milk. So this one comes in a huge container. So this is 250 ml or 8.4 oz, so a lot. This sunscreen is made like for the whole family, so from baby to children to adult. When I mean babies, I mean at least 1 year old babies. It is for the face and also for the body. So I have to say that Bioderma is one of those French brands that are very, very serious about sunscreen protection. And for a very long time, Bioderma has always come up with very high protection. Sunscreen, and in general, a good sign is when you are looking at a brand and you see that you only have SPF 50 plus and SPF 30, it is always a good sign. It means that the brand does understand that under SPF 30, the protection level is far too low. And if you are not new to my channel, you will know that I only recommend SPF 50 plus and to never go below. And this is the case of the Family Milk. This is an SPF of 50 plus. So I've been eyeing this sunscreen for a very long time, almost since Bioderma actually launched it. I was not sure that I was going to buy it simply because, as you can see, it is huge. I currently have at home probably around 50 sunscreen or something like that. So it's one of the reasons, but very recently, one of my beautiful subscribers just told me that the UVA protection of this one is of 42. So of course, high SPF with super high UVA protection factor, I am all about this. So this is what made me decide to really try it. What is very weird is that a couple of years before, probably like 3 or 4 years, something like that, Bioderma used to disclose already the PPD value. They call it the in vivo PPD value. So I don't know if they use the Calipa methods and therefore they extrapolate the PPD from it. The Calipa methods is the one that is used in Europe, or if they use the PPD method that they use in Japan. So this I don't know, but most of the time the UVA protection factor requirements from the Europe give the same results as the Japanese one. The difference is that in Europe, the UVA protection factor has to be at least 1/3 of the SPF. So this one is an SPF of 50 plus, so it's SPF 60 or above. Therefore, the UVA protection will be of a minimum of 20 using the Calipa method. In Japan, they determine the PPD using an in vivo method, and then they use the PA rating, and for pluses is equivalent to a PPD value of 16, but the results from the Calipa method and from the Japanese one is the same. The only difference is that when you get an SPF 50 in Japan, you know that it is a PPD value of 16 or maybe more. And in Europe, you know that when you will get whatever SPF 50 plus, it will be always an equivalent of PPD value of 20 or above. And Bioderma used to disclose them, but you don't find them anymore in the French website. From time to time, you find it in the international website. And one of my subscribers told me that you can find it in the Spanish website. And this is where I indeed saw that the PPD value of this one is 42. So this is a super high protection sunscreen. So something also important to mention is that this one is a waterproof sunscreen, and it also has this technology that you can reapply it even on wet skin. So definitely this sunscreen has been formulated for those of you who are basically on vacation and you are going to go to the beach or to the swimming pool. And if it is the case, I remind you that after each bath, I do invite you to reapply the sunscreen, especially on the face. They are supposed to last for 2 hours for the waterproof test. But as soon as you towel yourself or you take many baths, I always recommend to reapply even more frequently to make sure that the layer of sunscreen will not be disturbed. So the first thing that we are going to do is to, first of all, look at the filters. As a quick reminder, every sunscreen has to be, first of all, judged by the SPF, But the UVA protection, if you know them, for example, in the United States, it is never disclosed. You only know that it is a broad spectrum, but it could be a super low UVA protection or a super high one. You don't know it. In Europe, like I said, it is a requirement by the law. And in the Japanese system, it is the PA rating, but it's always better to have the proper value of the UVA protection. And then once you know this, you can have a look at the filters because it gives you an idea of how well the filter system is. So the first filter is the UVNOL A+, which is a photosensible filter. It filters mainly UVA type 1. Then we find Homosalat. Homosalat is a UVB absorber. It is not one of the best in the sense that even with a super high concentration, it doesn't help to achieve super high SPF, but it is an excellent one to dilute other sunscreen filters. Then we have what I call the iconic Tinosol S, because it is a broad spectrum organic filter that filters UVB, UVA type 2, and also UVA type 1. This one is excellent. Then we have Octil salicylate, which is mainly a UVB absorbent. And the last one is UVNOL T150, that is one of the best UVB filter because even at a very low concentration, it helps to achieve a super high SPF. So overall, the filtering system is excellent. The reason is because you have a lot of redundancy for UVB, UVA type 1, and for the UVA type 2, it is mainly achieved by the Tinosol S, but also by the other filters, because for example, UVNOL A+ also does absorb a little bit in the UVA type 2, so it just had to the one from the Tinosol S. What you also find in this formula is, I would say, the Bioderma blends of humectants. So in almost all Bioderma products, you find complex sugars like fructooligosaccharide, xylitol, mannitol, also rhamnose, and etc. And those one are the type of humectant that you will find in all Bioderma. And you also have vitamin E in the form of alpha tocopherol, which has been shown to be an antioxidant for the skin. In terms of notorious allergen, they is known for the reason that it is fragrance-free. You don't have any what I call weird botanical extract that might trigger skin allergy. You also don't have the notorious filters that are known to trigger skin sensitivity, such as octoquinone, for example. So overall, I would say that it is a very safe formula. So now, already the tricky part with those type of sunscreen is, of course, the texture, but also the finish. And the reason is because to achieve that high level of protection in terms of UVB, but also in terms of UVA, you do need a lot of filters. And in general, the type of sunscreen contains roughly 20% of filters. So it means a lot. And those filters are mainly really greasy, so hence the really greasy feeling that you can get from the sunscreens. So the texture is described as a milk. It is actually a sort of hybrid between, I would say, a cream and a lotion and a gel cream, something like that. It really reminds me a little bit of the texture, at least in the beginning, of the Clarins, the Soft Airy UV Essence, because as you can see, it comes out of the tube like a cream, but as soon as you spread it, it transforms into sort of this essence. But the difference is that with the Clarins, you have this very fresh and watery essence feel, but with this one, you definitely have the feel of an oily essence, I would say, so something very emollient for the skin. But that doesn't feel very creamy. The texture is nice, it also spreads super easily on the skin, not to the point where you might risk to have a streaky application like some of the Japanese sunscreens, such as the Skin Aqua, the Super Moisturized Milk, for example. This one has a wonderful texture. It is very lightweight, but you need to be very careful because when you apply it a little bit, it goes a very long way, and therefore you can have a very streaky application. And with those sunscreen, I really encourage you to apply two coats of sunscreen and a lot of them. With this one, it will be easier to have an even layer of sunscreen, which is what you do want. None of the filters that is used here have a white cast, and indeed this is a sunscreen that is 100% transparent, so whatever your skin color is, you can definitely use this one, which is amazing. There is also no filters that may sting your eyes, so it is also safe to use it on your eye area, and actually Bioderma recommend it also on the eye area, which is awesome. The only thing that is a bit so-so is that it is still very oily, and it does have a very dewy finish at the end. This is not something that you cannot work with, in the sense that it does work beautifully under makeup. This is currently the sunscreen that I have, and I did apply a little bit of foundation before I start this video, and it blended beautifully, especially if you choose a foundation that is silicone based and pretty dry. I would say it does work well under it, but still it is dewy. So if you have super oily skin, this sunscreen will not be for you for sure. If you have a very combination skin, especially with a very oily T-zone, it will be also trickier to use. But know that if you put a little bit of powder on top, it does work pretty well, and also the finish is pretty nice. But on its own, it does leave a very oily feeling on the skin. I also remind you that even though it is greasy, you still need to apply a lot of it in order to have the protection mentioned on the package. So you do need a minimum of 1/4 of a teaspoon for your face, another 1/4 of a teaspoon for your neck, or if you don't have any teaspoon, you can also use a finger length, so a whole finger for your face and for your neck. And I always encourage you to apply even more than that. So overall, I would say that I am pretty happy with this sunscreen. I have a normal skin to slightly combination on the T-zone, but not that much. And definitely if you live in the North Hemisphere, you are now transitioning in the cold month of the year, so this sunscreen is fine for everyday use, but don't expect to have this very beautiful texture such as the one from the Japanese one. So comment down below and tell me if you have any questions regarding this sunscreen. If you like this video, please thumbs up. You can also subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to ring the bell to not miss any of my new videos. You can also follow me on Instagram. I am Cyril Laurent. I have also a lot of content here. I thank you so much for watching me, and I will see you next time. Au revoir. Bye bye.